Hey guys, welcome back to Wick's Garage. I'm your host, Dwayne. This week, guys, I'm gonna tear apart my brake pedal cluster, put all new bushings in, have the pieces powder coated, and put it all back together nice and pretty so it's ready to go back in the car. So check it out. All right, I'm ready to put my pedal cluster back together. I have my trusty schematic from 74 to 77. This is a 77 pedal box. Now, the powder coater did powder coat over some areas that I'll need to take off, such as this area here. There's some powder coat there. Slide in there, like so. Probably don't actually need to sand that down. I think because this piece just simply has the bearings in it. I may just tap these in with a mallet. Well, I got some sandpaper handy, why not? Ream it out a little. Get the high spots off there. Same thing on the other side, there's two bearings. So go in there. These, I should say, not bearings, but bushings. Brass bushings that go in there. Thank you. The brake pedal just simply drops down in this housing, like so. And that piece will go in there. I think I am going to have to sand this one off here, looks like. Test fit this in here. Definitely snug on this end. Let's see what the dealio is. Alrighty, got one of my favorite tools in the garage, Dremel. It's very handy for lots of small precision jobs. Oops, forgot I was gonna put the bearing or the bushing in this piece here. If you orientate it in the correct direction, it just slides right in. Done. So we just have a sanding barrel on a low speed. We don't want to take the metal down. Just want to remove all the powder coat off there. Do the other side too. Once again, I have succeeded. Like a glove. All right. Then there's this weird plastic bushing. All right, I think I'm ready for my high pressure grease. This basically just sticks on the end there, like so. And then your pedal goes in the right way. Boom. And this piece goes in, but I do have to put the spring on, which I am going to rattle can real quick, I believe. Okay, got the clutch pedal in. Spring was a challenge to get it in there with the tension without scratching everything up. This is just a little clutch pad replacement that goes in this little thing here. Okay, ready to put the roll punch in. Alright, I have the roll pin in. That's always the hardest part of the build. Basically what I did was I set it on that block. Well, first I pressed it in as far as it would go, and then I pounded it in the rest of the way on that block. I do have this 7mm. Which sets down in there, makes it easier to keep it on the pin. So it is, you know, successfully all the way through on both sides. Now I just found this special bolt goes in there and holds this brace on. So let's go ahead and do that. Just goes in here like so. Gonna have your new pedals, pedal covers. All right, guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of Wick's Garage. I want to thank Aussie Sales, link in the description, as well as TI Porsche Products, TIPorscheProducts.com, and Andy over at Worth USA. These are the control arms I'm going to be putting on the car. I've already had a set rebuilt, the original ones off this car. However, I've sold the 77 mag trans axle that came with this car and picked up a new transmission. I'm going to show you guys that next week, so tune in. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.